Emotional orchestral beats. They're so wavy, and I just made one that is like top tier wavy, okay? So I'm gonna show you how to make them, what my process is, and give you a little bit of sauce, because that's what we do on this channel. Just a little bit of sauce here and there. Orchestral melodies are usually based upon like a small something and then built upon. That's how I like to think about things, you know. That's the sort of thing I was taught in school, and that the thing that I started off was these two chords. So I actually started the MIDI in E minor, and well, it's three chords. So the chords are E minor, C major, and D major. But this is a C major seventh chord, and this is E minor seventh as well. To make the chords a bit more interesting, what I did was pitch up the middle note of the chord. And then what I did was add the rest of the notes in. As you can see here, you've got the two notes here that finishes off the E minor chord. And what I did also was add a lot of rhythm, like movement within the chords. So normally you play chords like dun, dun, dun. But here I played it like dun, 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 dun. So this and this makes the dun, dun, and this is the dun, and then this is the dun, dun. And it just makes it more interesting to listen to, and it sounds very wavy. Here we I made the root note come in first, and then the rest of the chord came in, and it gives it that dun, you know what I mean? And then added some grace notes to fill it back to the loop. Added this little thing right here, this little pattern, which basically just goes down the scale, and it skips the C note because C in E minor doesn't sound that good. Know the music theory reason, drop it down in the comments. Yeah, what I did was just add some flam notes or grace notes, I don't know, either way you can call it. Sounds so good. Yeah, here just added some more filler notes to transition, and the same here, just added a little bit more extra notes just to progress it a bit more. But here, I think something that made it really like just so smooth and lovely was the way that this, the E velocity is really low. So it's sort of like, dun, you lightly press it and then goes harder into the rest of the chord. So you can hear the duh, 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 these notes here, and they're sort of swung, and then the note hits, and it just, yeah. It's just lovely, mate. So before we continue, smash like. Alright, cool. Then what I did was pitch it down like 6 or 7 or like 5 or something to A sharp minor. And this is what it sounds like. The pitch down just adds levels to the waviness. Alright, and then the next thing I moved to was this these violins, and it just plays a little top melody on top of the chords. So and then I layered that with a cello because I wanted it to have more like warmth and depth. So this cello sounds like this. It plays the same notes just a couple octaves below. Then I added this piccolo, I believe. Yeah, so a piccolo is just a high flute, so it's just a smaller flute that plays more high pitched, and it plays the same melody as the cellos and the violin, but with a couple more notes to sort of make the notes flow together a bit more. And then again, what I did was add a lower layer of a flute, and it plays the same melody and just makes it sound thicker. Get the idea. And all together, this is what the melody will sound like. Kind of reminds me of How to Train Your Dragon a little bit. So that's why I named the beat Dragon. If you know the theme for that, kind of reminds me of that, like the little end phrase here. But you know, and then what I did was bounce out the melody in the four arrangement. So I arranged it a bit like this, very very simple. 3 8-bars and 3 8-bars, simple dimple. And then I bounced it out and pitched it down 5, so it goes to like F sharp or F minor or something like that. It sounds very sampled. That's because I added this EQ, removed the low end, and also added this plugin called Dirty Tape, which is basically like an RC20 sort of vibe. It's a vintage tape saturator emulator. Don't know if you can get this anymore, but if you can, then maybe I'll put it down below in the description. I don't know, you're gonna have to look or ask me in the comments if I don't, and if you want it. And then just added some easy drums, mate. These drums are so easy. This is the 808, follows the root notes. Play them. Simple, made it a bit louder and a bit shorter right here, using the out knob and the boost and EQ knob. So it just sounds very punchy and very bouncy. And then the rest of the drums right here, pretty simple. Got the kick from Unwanted Drums, got a snare from Unwanted Drums, kick, snare, hi-hats from Unwanted Drums, and unfortunately this snare is not from Unwanted Drums, but it sounds good, so I did the drums together. And I added some like risers. So this is the first riser from Unwanted Drums. And this is riser 2 from Unwanted Drums. Just a white noise riser. And then what you do, if you layer them together, it sounds a bit more like this. If you play it at the drop. Rodaway would kill this beat, you know, his new album. He would definitely kill this. Like, bruh. Watch this video right now.